Christian Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents Created for Purpose by Guillermo Maldonado, narrated by Jim Denison. Preface. Sooner or later, we all ask ourselves the reason for our existence. Many people never find a satisfactory answer to this question because they are looking in the wrong places. That answer can only be found in the one who created us, God, our Heavenly Father. The truth is, you are a glorious creation of God with a unique and eternal purpose. This means that you are not an accident. Your presence on this earth is not a mistake. Neither is it insignificant. You are wanted here and needed. Yet Satan, the enemy of our souls, works incessantly to rob us of our identity, purpose, potential, and destiny because he wants to stop the advancement of God's kingdom on earth. That is why, after we understand our significance as children of God, it is necessary for us to receive a revelation of our calling and destiny and then begin to walk it out in the power of God's Spirit. The Holy Spirit inspired my heart to write Created for Purpose to share this revelation that God has a purpose for every person's life. This book began with God's work in my own life, in which He revealed my purpose in Him and the process by which we come to understand our purpose. I can't keep this treasure to myself. I have never acted selfishly with what God has given me. I want to share this knowledge so that thousands, perhaps millions of people in this generation and the ones to come can know their purpose and reach their destiny. In this book, you will find topics such as God's original intention for every human being, how to position ourselves in our purpose, and how to follow the path to fulfilling it. I talk about the vital process of forming our character, the anointing that empowers us to accomplish our purpose, how to live for a purpose rather than for a need, and the indicators that allow us to identify our calling. I believe that listening to this book will be the beginning of a supernatural journey in your life. Once you know your purpose, you will never go back to the way you used to live. Dive deeply into this revelation. It will help you make sense of what has happened in your life in the past, and it will give you a future and a hope for the rest of your life, on into eternity. It will lead you to wake up every day full of energy, joy, and happiness. You will no longer live in a state of depression, boredom, or loneliness, because being in God's purpose fills us with His eternal life. You did not arrive on this earth by chance, and you are not here by accident or as the result of an error. God created you with an intentional and specific purpose so that His kingdom can advance, filling the earth with His joy, love, and peace. Come to know your purpose and enter into a glorious destiny today, here and now. 1. God's original intent. One of the biggest problems many people face today is not a lack of time, although they may think that's the issue. Rather, it's the exhaustion and emptiness they feel, even after working hard and being involved in many activities and tasks, because they don't have a clear direction in life or know what they really want to achieve. When we don't know our purpose, it is like trying to push against the heavy waves of the sea, or like walking around aimlessly. We never get anywhere. I believe such a lack of purpose is the reason for the increasing number of suicides in the United States in recent years. When people don't know what to live for, death can seem appealing to them. But when they take their own life, they go from human uncertainty into a spiritual realm that is unknown to them. Sadly, a large percentage of men and women die without understanding why God created them or discovering their purpose on earth. When our lives lack meaning, time itself can become a difficult burden to carry. In contrast, those who know their purpose walk safely through life and are even pursued by success. When I refer to success, I do not necessarily mean achieving fame or becoming rich. especially since both of these conditions tend to occupy the lowest rungs on the happiness scale. True success comes from doing the will of God and fulfilling the purpose for which we were created. Everything else is extra. Successful people conquer kingdoms, create nations, and shape history. History does not make them. On the contrary, they make history. Moses freed the Hebrews from slavery, defeating the Egyptian kingdom in the process, and established a new nation, Israel, shaping the course of God's people in history. Jesus Christ, by dying on the cross and rising from the dead, overcame the kingdom of darkness, brought the kingdom of God to earth, and divided the history of humanity into two, before Christ and after Christ. But it is not only great figures like Moses or Jesus who make their mark on history. When any person dares to think and live differently from the norm, obeying God and following His purposes, they will leave their own mark on the world. If you want to influence the history of your life and that of your family, your city, and even your nation, you have come to the right place. Created for Purpose will guide you in how to produce that kind of influence and change. God created everything with purpose. Every human being wants to know the purpose for their existence. In fact, there are four main questions that we all seek to answer for our lives. 1. Who am I? This is a question of identity. 2. Where do I come from? This is a question of origin. 3. Why am I here? This is a question of purpose. 4. Where am I going? This is a question of destiny. We will experience genuine happiness when we find the answers to these crucial questions, and the only one who can reveal the answers to us is our Creator. People who lack purpose often do not understand or accept themselves, so they end up competing with those around them. They will try to imitate someone else's appearance, seek to take the place that belongs to another, or attempt to steal the blessings that have been poured out on others. Such competition arises from a missing sense of identity and an ignorance of the fact that each individual has a distinct purpose in life. Those who do not know their purpose will always be insecure. God has a purpose for everyone and everything He created. We can define purpose as the original intent or reason for which something was created. In the case of human beings, our purpose is the original intent of God, His determination and desire for us when He gave us life. When I refer to our creation by God, I am not talking primarily about our earthly birth, but rather our design by Him in eternity, outside of the chronos, or chronological time, that we function under in the world. Thus, contrary to what many people think, life begins in heaven, not on earth. God designed us in heavenly places before we came to live on the earth. As He told the prophet Jeremiah, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I sanctified you. I ordained you a prophet to the nations." See Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 5. Since everything in God begins with His original intention, we were a fully formed idea in His mind before we ever received our physical bodies. Therefore, we can say that before we are born, we already are, and we have already been given a unique purpose by our Creator. Seeing things in this way, we must conclude that abortion is a sin, not only because it is the taking of a human life, but also because it is an attack on a divine purpose. No matter how many weeks or months a fetus has gestated, he or she is a person, has life, and was created by God with a purpose. Nobody has the right to truncate that divine purpose. Purpose gives our lives significance because, once we follow it, we begin to make a difference in the world. Without purpose, our day-to-day life lacks meaning. It becomes merely the passage of time. In effect, those who live without knowing their purpose act irresponsibly because they do not know how to properly value their life, and they end up wasting it. This is the reason why many people are unhappy, dissatisfied, empty, unfocused, depressed, and alone. Furthermore, God has given each human being a period of time to fulfill their purpose on earth. That is why it is necessary for us to understand and start to follow that purpose as soon as possible. We cannot waste time. We must live with a clear and defined mission for our lives. The Bible states, "To everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under heaven." See Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1. It is time to discover your purpose and begin to achieve it. The breath of life. In Genesis chapter 1, verse 26, God said, "Let us make man in our image, according to our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth." Then, in Genesis chapter 2, verse 7, we read, "The Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living being." God is a spiritual being, and these verses affirm that man was first created as a spiritual being in his image, and then was given physical form out of the dust of the earth. It was only when God breathed his pneuma, or breath of life, into the body made of dust that man was given physical life. This shows us that, from the beginning of time, humanity has lived in two worlds, the spiritual and the physical. The spiritual world was as real as the natural world. The first human beings, Adam and Eve, maintained communion with God in the Garden of Eden, which was the atmosphere of His presence. This communication took place through the spiritual part of their being. The spiritual world is just as real now as it was then. The great difference between then and now is that, sometime after creation, the spirit of human beings died because of their sin, or rebellion against God. See Genesis chapter 3. In a state of spiritual death, it is difficult for a person to access the original heavenly atmosphere for which they were created. That is why it was necessary for God's Son, Jesus, to come to earth. The spirit of any person can only come alive again in Christ Jesus. See, for example, Ephesians chapter 2, verse 5 and Colossians chapter 2, verse 13. He rescues us from the world of sin and enables us to live in the atmosphere of heaven, where we can have continual access to the Father and the realm of His Spirit. God establishes the end from the beginning. To live according to our purpose, we must understand that God never does anything as merely a test or an experiment, that when He creates something, it is because He has already given it a purpose and knows exactly how His creation will respond. In Ephesians chapter 1, verses 4 and 5, it says, "God chose us in Him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before Him in love, having predestined us to adoption as sons by Jesus Christ to Himself, according to the good pleasure of His will." To grasp this passage, we first need to explore what it means to be predestined. The original Greek word means to determine beforehand or to ordain. This idea indicates to give an end or destiny to. One's destiny is guided by a series of invariable outcomes that lead a person to their goal or end. Therefore, to predestine someone is to establish their end from the beginning, or to decree their destiny in advance. This is the way God works in our lives. In Isaiah chapter 46, verses 9 and 10, it says, "For I am God, and there is no other. I am God, and there is none like me, declaring the end from the beginning, and from ancient times things that are not yet done, saying, My counsel shall stand, and I will do all my pleasure." God predetermined when and how He would save human beings from sin and death, and the enemy, Satan, who opposes God, could not prevent that from happening. Jesus Christ, God's Son, who is fully divine and fully human, died on the cross on a specific day in human history according to the chronos time that governs the earth. However, in eternity, his life had already been delivered for the salvation of the entire human race. He is the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. See Revelation chapter 13, verse 8. The Word of God declares that only by the work of the cross can we be redeemed from our aimless conduct with the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb without blemish and without spot. He indeed was foreordained before the foundation of the world, but was manifest in these last times for us. See 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 18 through 20. When the Scriptures say that we were predestined, they emphasize that God has a purpose for each one of us. We were created in eternity, in a spiritual environment, before the foundation of the world, to have an exclusive destiny previously traced in the mind of God. There are no coincidences in Him. Anything that He formed was first finished in His supernatural mind. He determines the purpose and then shapes the one who will fulfill it. We need to discover and live out the purpose He has for us. However, we must keep in mind that God has also given human beings free will. His ultimate plans for humanity will always come to pass. It is up to us whether we will participate in those plans or forfeit our place in them. We exist because it is the supreme desire of God for us to be here. Most human beings believe that they exist to satisfy their own selfish desires. But in reality, we exist to satisfy and please God. God is not selfish, and His unconditional love seeks the good of all mankind. His plans for us are better than any personal desires we may have. You are not an accident. Let's return to a scripture passage concerning the life of Jeremiah that faithfully expresses the concept of purpose and predestination, as well as the prophetic role that Jeremiah would fulfill in the history of Israel. In Jeremiah chapter 1, verses 4 and 5, it says, "Then the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I sanctified you. I ordained you a prophet to the nations." The phrase, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you," reveals that this occurred in eternity, outside of measured time. We have seen that the same was true in the life of Jesus, who was sent on a mission to earth from eternity. In Luke chapter 4, verse 43, Jesus talks about a central aspect of that eternal purpose. "I must preach the kingdom of God to the other cities also, because for this purpose I have been sent." See also Mark chapter 1, verse 38. No one arrives on earth unless their purpose is already determined in heaven. You are not an experiment or an accident. You are on earth because, in the mind of God, you are already a finished product with a purpose and destiny. People may tell you that you are useless and will never be successful in life. The good news is that if you are here, it is because God created you, formed you, and gave you purpose. You are important to His plan. Never accept other people's negative opinions of you, because nobody knows a finished product better than the one who created it. Additionally, when you walk in God's purpose, you can be assured that everything in your life is working for good. In Romans chapter 8, verse 28, it says, "And we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are the called according to His purpose." God knows why and for what end He created you. If you search for it from your heart, He will reveal to you the purpose of your life, and you can begin to live it out. In this regard, don't allow the human circumstances of your birth to define you. You might have been born out of wedlock or from a prostitute's womb. You might have been conceived against your mother's will due to rape. Because humanity rebelled against God, we live in a fallen world. God is well aware of the circumstances under which each of us was conceived. Yet in His foreknowledge, He created us all with a purpose, a good purpose. God created you in eternity and gave you a divine destiny. This may explain the course of certain events in your life. Perhaps you almost died in your mother's womb, but you lived against all odds. Perhaps you were diagnosed with a terminal illness, but you survived. It might be that you were abused, rejected, and mistreated, but you endured. You must realize that God's adversary, the devil, always persecutes those who can ruin his evil plans. However, you are alive now because you have a great purpose, and God fights on your behalf. Thus, eternally speaking, you are not the product of human invention. You were conceived due to a creative idea from God. No matter what your background, what you must do now is begin to walk through life with the assurance that if God began the work in you, He will finish it. See Philippians chapter 1, verse 6. If you don't understand these truths, you will not be able to know or fulfill your purpose. The seed of potential. Almost everything in creation begins in the form of a seed, and each seed represents a potential mature entity that can bear fruit. Furthermore, each fruit that is produced bears its own seeds, so that the original seed is multiplied exponentially. Although this is a natural process in creation, many men and women end their days without bearing fruit and multiplying their seed. Like a seed, in order to give life, we must first die to ourselves before we can be reborn and multiply. Jesus said, "Most assuredly, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the ground and dies, it remains alone. But if it dies, it produces much grain." See John chapter 12, verse 24. We see this process in the life of Jesus, who had more followers and produced more miracles through those followers after He died and was resurrected than He had beforehand. His seed soon bore a multitude of fruit, and the numerous seeds from that fruit have spread throughout the world and continue to multiply to this day. Some people fail to produce fruit in their lives due to an ignorance of their potential. Others are selfish, not willing to go through the process that enables them to bear fruit, because there is a cost. Still others experience the enemy's attack upon their purpose, and they don't understand how to counteract it. Cemeteries are full of the remains of talented humans who went down to the grave carrying the wisdom they never shared, books or songs they never wrote, inventions they never created, medical breakthroughs they never made, and technology they never developed. Good purposes that never saw the light of day. You were not created just to breathe, eat, and pay bills, nor were you created just to warm a chair in a church or be merely one of the crowd. You were created for greatness. Just as birds are designed to fly through the air and fish to swim in the water, you were designed to live in a particular atmosphere, the very presence of God. You were not made for mediocrity. You were made for success. Do not let anything or anyone negate your unique identity. You are a child of God, created with a divine purpose in life. That is a truth that nobody can take from you. The divine force of purpose. While the purpose of every human being is born in heaven, it is essentially carried out on earth. Yet because our purpose originates in God, it is supernatural, and it has a divine force that drives it to fulfillment. How can we know God's purpose for us on earth? How can we know our destiny? By divine revelation, which comes through developing intimacy with God and His Word. In coming chapters, I will show you how to discern and fulfill the purpose that God has given you. But before we move on, I would like to guide you in two prayers. The first is to receive Jesus into your heart, because our very first purpose as human beings is to love and serve God. See, for example, Matthew chapter 22, verses 36 through 38. Please repeat this prayer out loud. Heavenly Father, I recognize that I am a sinner and that my sin separates me from you. I believe that Jesus died for me on the cross and that God the Father raised him from the dead. Today, I repent of all my sins and voluntarily confess Jesus as my Lord and Savior. I renounce any mindset that is contrary to your word, as well as any agreement with the desires of the sinful nature and with the devil. Instead, I make a covenant with Jesus to love and serve him. Lord, I ask you to enter my heart and change my life. If I died today, I know I would be in your arms. Amen. Now, repeat the following prayer with all of your heart so that your purpose may be revealed. Heavenly Father, I come before your presence, recognizing that I do not know the purpose for which you created me. I acknowledge that it has been difficult for me to submit to the process of dying to myself so that I can fulfill my destiny in you. Today, I surrender in faith, knowing that your plans for me are better than any self-centered desires I may have. I ask that the Holy Spirit would reveal to me your purpose for my life, and that you would give me the ability to let go of anything that is not good for me and doesn't build me up. Now, I declare that I will be trained and processed by you, and that I will achieve my purpose in life. Please give me your grace, your discernment, and your power to do great things in my generation. In the name of Jesus, amen. Testimonies of finding and fulfilling purpose. No greater joy than living in God's will. John Lafitte might have become an important NASA engineer, gone to space, and been recognized worldwide. However, he chose to fulfill God's purpose for his life instead. For nearly a decade, he has helped thousands of people transform their lives, teaching the Word of God with revelation and demonstrating the supernaturality of God. Growing up, I knew that everyone had a purpose, but I could not prove it. I did not know how to find it, and I did not know of anyone who could teach me. The only guides I had were my parents, and they always told me that I should do something for the good of humanity. At school, I realized that I was a good student, and it was easy for me to achieve good grades. I continually challenged myself with increasingly more difficult courses. I was a logical thinker, yet I was too shy to speak in front of people. I decided to study aerospace engineering and become an astronaut, graduating from MIT and the University of Michigan. However, as I continued my studies, I had a supernatural encounter with God. The Lord placed in me a deep hunger for His Word, and I studied it continuously for 3 years. I did not know that He was preparing me for my purpose. I attended a church, and one day they prophesied that I had a call to teach the Word of God. While I listened to that, I still had my own plans. After graduating, I returned to Miami and began to attend King Jesus Ministry. When Apostle Maldonado met me, he perceived from the Spirit that I had a call to teach the Word of God. Many doors and opportunities opened for me to teach the Word. At that time, I had an excellent job in engineering and good career opportunities. I made a request to be accepted into the NASA astronaut program, and I was far along in the selection process when God suddenly confirmed His will to me personally, telling me that I should stop those efforts in order to dedicate myself to fulfilling His purpose. At King Jesus Ministry, I began to volunteer as an interpreter and had the opportunity to be close to a number of men and women of God. Many of them prophesied about my ministerial call. One day, my supervisor at work called me to his office to tell me that they wanted to promote me to vice president with a salary increase. At the same time, Apostle Maldonado asked me to work full-time with him in the ministry. It was time to make a decision. Do I follow my own plans or those of God? In that process, I learned that God takes us to a place where we have to choose between doing our will or His. I turned down the promotion, quit my job, and went to work at King Jesus Ministry. There, I was put in charge of the Supernatural Leadership Institute and later the University of the Supernatural Ministry, USM. Over the years, I have seen God move in many powerful ways, and today we see people around the world moving in His supernatural power thanks to the training we provide through the Institute and University. For example, not long ago, a group of USM students and leaders from our campus in Bolivia went out to evangelize in the streets, demonstrating miracles, signs, and wonders. A young woman prayed for a man who was in a wheelchair in the middle of a plaza. To everyone's amazement, the man got up from the chair and started running and jumping. This man was very well known in that part of the city. Many people, including the police, gathered in the square because of the news. After seeing this miracle, another 20 people there accepted Jesus as their Lord and Savior. We have also seen God move in Chiapas, Mexico, thanks to the campus we have in Central America. After taking a course on prayer and being activated to pray for the sick, some of the students visited a hospital and prayed for a man who had been in a coma for 15 days. The doctors gave no hope for his recovery. However, as the students prayed for this man, the power of God lifted him out of the coma. Shortly thereafter, he was taken out of intensive care and is now recovering. If I had not left my scientific career to dedicate myself to this ministry, I would not be seeing the wonders that God can do through someone who follows His purpose. I have already spent about 9 years serving God full-time, but it seems like I started just yesterday. Now I understand why God made me the way I am. Being so studious and logical has helped to make me a good teacher of the Word of God. Supernaturally, He removed all fear of speaking in public from me. Now I can teach or preach in front of thousands of people and do so with boldness. I can see the hand and blessing of God in my life and in my family. I am also seeing God's supernatural provision because my daughter received a full scholarship to study at Yale University. There is no greater joy than living in God's purpose for our life. Today, I know that I have entered into my purpose, and I enjoy dedicating my life to helping others enter into theirs. Called to be a supernatural doctor. When Andrew Steiger entered medical school, he was full of doubts about whether he was right for his chosen field. However, he believed in his purpose and persevered. Today, he is one of the best orthopedic surgeons in the world. However, he refers to himself as a supernatural doctor, a man used by the Lord to rebuild people's hands while also bringing divine healing to God's people through prayer. Becoming a surgeon was an intense struggle for me. I went to several universities until I finished my residency at Southern Illinois University in Springfield, Illinois, which took me 5 more years. I felt that I should dedicate myself to orthopedic surgery, but I knew it was one of the most competitive specialties that a student can choose. Many times, I questioned God for guiding me to that particular field, and as other students made known their desire to pursue the same specialty, I wanted to switch to something else, but I felt that God did not want me to make a change.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.